Hello, today I'll show you how to import brush sets and color swatches from the Procreate Resource Center to onto your Procreate. So I have a brush set picked up. If you don't know which set this is from an illustrator and designer called Tuhis. I mentioned the link to this brush set in my recent newsletter. If you haven't signed up for my newsletter yet, just go make sure you sign up. So let's just scroll here. And there are so many links for Dropbox. For this, first you have to set up a Dropbox account and have this installed on your iPad. And now let's click on one of these links and it's going to open up in your Dropbox and show up like this. So obviously it does not show any preview, but that's okay. Click on these three dots right here and say save to my Dropbox. Now it'll ask you to where you want to save. So I'm just going to click on separate location. And I will actually create a folder and mark it as test because I have already downloaded it and click on done. So you have created a folder. This folder has nothing in it. And now we'll choose this folder and say save. All right, so this has been already saved onto our system. Now what we can do is click on cancel. And here, if you click on home, you will see the folder test. If you cannot see it here, just click on home or you can click on files. And it'll show up all the folders that you have. And now let's click on test. I'm just gonna take up my Apple Pencil because it's easier. Okay, and then you have your brush set right here. So once click on it, and now click on three dots again and say export. And if you scroll here and say copy to Procreate. So let's just copy to Procreate. It's done and it opens up Procreate. Now I'll just, if you just go back, to any, click on your brush set, and usually on the top you can see the brush set that was exported. And that's it, that's how simple it is to export a brush set into your Procreate. And now let's look at color swatches. I'm just going to go back here and I will go back to discussions and scroll down all the way to resources. And here, let's just click on some swatches. So you have these swatches and there are many links under this, as you can see. So I'm just gonna go ahead and click on one of these neon links because I don't have the neon colors. So I'll just click on this one. It'll open up in Dropbox, but it says cannot display links. So this sometimes has problems. So for me, sometimes works out when I go ahead and take the Dropbox off, go back, click, and now it loads. It's the same procedure. I'm just going to save to my Dropbox because I plan to use it some other time. I'll just put it in test, save, and then cancel, and then it's already here. So I'm just gonna click on these three dots, export, copy to Procreate. And now if I click on swatches, and if you go ahead, should be able to see it almost to the bottom of the, there you go, all the swatches are ready. Now if you want this to display right in the top, you can just click on set default. So whenever you open the color palette, this will pop up, and obviously it'll pop up here as well. So it's pretty easy to work with so many swatches or palettes that you have, and because it's like a lot of them. I have mentioned a favorite palette of mine, that is Mako Imtoba, and I really like this color palette. So feel free to go ahead and check it out and download it onto your Procreate. And if you do create something, do let me know, because these colors are amazing. And I'm so glad there are people out there who take their time to create these palettes and put them out so that people like us can use it and feel happy about it. Thanks for watching. Bye.